Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and attending your classes, online classes regularly. Please attend your classes regularly, okay? So students, we will continue with the same chapter, that is life processes. So in the previous class we discussed about digestion of food in stomach, okay? So please open page number 99 here. So I ask one question from you, that in stomach which nutrient is digested by the action of pepsin, and some of the students WhatsApp me the answer, and the answer was correct, that is pepsin digest proteins. Okay, so students, don't hesitate, you can WhatsApp the answer if any question is asked. It does not matter if the answer is wrong. Okay, now here the food, it reaches here, and here I told you that gastric juice contains three things, or it is made up of three things: HCl, hydrochloric acid, mucus and pepsin. Pepsin is the enzyme. This pepsin is inactive, it does not act. Okay, it acts only when the food is acidic. So this hydrochloric acid, it makes the food acidic and thereby activating the pepsin. And this pepsin in the food, okay, this pepsin, it digests protein. So protein digestion begins in stomach, and the muscles of the stomach, they contract and relax, and they help in the further breakdown of the food to semi-solid or liquid. Okay, now the function of HCl, hydrochloric acid, is to kill the bacteria if it is present in the food, and to make the food acidic so that the pepsin can be activated, and pepsin, it digests proteins. Mucus is secreted because what is the function of mucus? This mucus, it forms the layers on the walls of the stomach. Okay, understood? So it protects the stomach walls from the secretions of hydrochloric acid. Okay, if mucus is not secreted, hydrochloric acid will cause the erosion of the inner lining of the stomach, leading to the formation of ulcers in the stomach. Is it clear? So after this, the food, it goes in the small intestine. Okay, you can see in this picture, this is the small intestine. So from here the food goes into the small intestine. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now students, this small intestine, it is the longest part of the alimentary canal. Okay, this small intestine, it is very very long structure, and this small intestine is highly coiled. Why it is highly coiled? Because it has to fit into a small space, the abdominal space. So this is highly coiled and it fits into the abdominal space. And the small intestine, though it is the longest part, but we call it a small intestine because it is very narrow. I hope all of you know the meaning of narrow. Now the length of the small intestine is different in different animals. It depends upon their feeding habits, like the food they feed. For example, in case of herbivores, they eat what? They eat plants, and plants have one complex carbohydrate which is called as cellulose, and which is very much difficult to digest. So in order to digest it completely, in herbivores the small intestine is long, whereas in carnivores they eat meat, and meat can be easily digested. So in carnivores, the length of the small intestine is small compared to herbivores. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now students, please see here, you know this is liver, this is pancreas. Now this liver, it produces bile juice, and this bile juice is stored in gallbladder. Okay, understood? And this is pancreas secretes one juice which is called as pancreatic juice, and this pancreatic juice has enzymes amylase, trypsin and lipase. Pancreas is a gland, and liver is also a gland, so they are the part of digestive system. I told you this before also. Now this small intestine. Okay, from the stomach, food goes to the small intestine. This small intestine is divided into three parts. One is duodenum. Okay, it is divided into how many parts? Students, please remember, it is very easy. It is divided into three parts: duodenum, the first part, then is jejunum and ileum. Okay, this duodenum, it is a C-shaped part of the small intestine. This is the middle part and this is the last part where actually the absorption of the food takes place. And in the small intestine, the complete digestion of food takes place. Food is completely digested, nutrients are completely digested to the simpler forms like carbohydrates, starch is completely digested to glucose, proteins are completely digested to amino acids, and fats are completely digested to fatty acids and glycerol. Now please pay attention, students, it is not given in your book, that is why. Just see, this is a C-shaped part. Can you see this? This is actually duodenum. Okay, and this middle part is the jejunum and the ileum. Now please remember one thing. Now gallbladder, suppose, see, I am drawing rough diagram. Now suppose this is gallbladder. Okay, this gallbladder, it stores bile. And can you see this? This is called as duct. What it is called? Duct. Now this bile, okay, this bile that is taken, okay, or transported through this duct. Understood? And this duct is called as bile duct. I hope it is clear. Now suppose this is pancreas. Okay, suppose this is pancreas. Now this pancreas, can you see? This pancreas, it is a gland, it also has duct. And this duct is called as pancreatic duct. What it is called? It is called pancreatic duct. I hope it is clear. So by pancreatic juice that is transferred or that is transported through pancreatic duct. Understood? Now what happened? This bile duct and this pancreatic duct, okay, they combine and they form a common duct. Okay, they form a common duct. Can you understand? Can you see? They form this common duct, which is called as hepatopancreatic duct. It is called as, this duct is called as hepato, from here, hepato, from here, pancreatic, hepatopancreatic duct, or it is also called as common bile duct. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, just to make it easier for you or to make the things clearer to you, I will show you this in some another book. I hope you all can see it clearly now. Can you see? This is stomach. Okay, this is duodenum. Okay, this is stomach and this is the, from here this intestine begins, and this is the first part of the intestine, the beginning of the intestine. The C-shaped part is called as duodenum. Okay, and this is the liver. This is liver, the largest gland of the human body. In human body, this produces bile. And this is the gallbladder. This gallbladder, it stores bile. And this duct, can you see here? This is the bile duct. Okay, this is bile duct. And this is pancreas. And in pancreas also there is a small duct which is called as pancreatic duct. Now this gallbladder, it stores bile, and this bile is carried by a bile duct, and this pancreas produces juice, pancreatic juice, which contains enzymes amylase, lipase and trypsin. Okay, now you can see here this bile duct and this pancreatic duct, they join together and they form a common bile duct. And this common bile duct, please see, opens in a C-shaped part of the intestine, that is duodenum. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, it opens in the C-shaped part of the intestine, which is called as duodenum. Here, it opens, you can see here, this it opens here. So, food from the stomach reaches in the C-shaped part of the intestine, that is duodenum. Now, pancreatic juice contains enzyme amylase, lipase and trypsin. And here, the enzymes are present in the inactive form. Enzymes act only if the food is alkaline. But the food in the stomach was acidic, and the same food when it enters in the duodenum is still acidic. Okay, so that food has to be converted into alkaline medium, which will activate the enzymes of the pancreatic juice. Now, this common bile duct which opens here in the duodenum part will bring bile juice. Okay, it brings bile juice from gallbladder. Okay, and it brings pancreatic juice from pancreas. So, the food here, it mixes with the bile juice as well as with the pancreatic juice. Now, pancreatic juice contains enzymes, but these enzymes are present in an inactive form. Only when the food is in alkaline medium, then only these enzymes, they get activated. Understood? So, bile juice, okay? Bile juice makes the food alkaline. Please remember, bile juice is also secreted here, and bile juice, it makes the food alkaline, and which activates the enzymes amylase, lipase and trypsin. Now, amylase digests which carbohydrate? Amylase helps in the digestion of starch. So, starch was already digested in the mouth, but it was not completely digested. So, this amylase of the pancreatic juice, I already told you, amylase is always digest carbohydrate. This amylase, it will further help in the digestion of starch. Okay, now then is trypsin. Trypsin helps in the further digestion of proteins, because in the stomach the complete digestion of proteins did not occur. Okay, then is lipase. Lipase helps in the digestion of fats, but here the lipase of the pancreatic juice will not act on bigger pieces of fats, because the fats in the intestine are present in a big fat globules. What we say big fat globules, and lipase cannot act on so big fat globules. So this big fat globules, okay, it has to be converted into small globules, and when it is converted into small globules or small pieces, then only the lipase acts. I hope it is clear. Now, this bile juice it breaks the bigger fat globules. First makes the food alkaline, then second it breaks big fat globules into small pieces, and this breaking of big fat globules into small pieces by bile is called as emulsification of fats. What it is called? Emulsification means to break. It is called as emulsification of fats, or fats are emulsified, means fats are broken. So this bile juice, it helps in the emulsification of fats, or you can say it breaks big fat globules into small pieces so that enzyme lipase can act on it. So when this bile juice is converted into, when these fat globules are converted into small pieces, then lipase enzyme, it acts on small fat pieces. Understood or no? Can you see nicely? So here the enzymes, they break amylase, breaks starch, then trypsin breaks proteins, and lipase, it acts on smaller pieces of fats which are broken by the bile. Okay, understood or no? So after this, I told you the intestine is divided into three parts, that is duodenum. You can see duodenum, jejunum and ileum. So food from this duodenum, it reaches into the middle part of the intestine. Okay, and here in this middle part of the intestine, that is jejunum, is present intestinal glands. The wall of the intestine has intestinal glands, and this intestinal glands also secretes some enzymes. Now the food from this duodenum, it reaches the intestine. Understood? Now when the food reaches the intestine, here in the walls of the intestine are present intestinal glands which secretes juice. Okay, so what will happen here? The complete digestion of starch, protein and fats takes place. Understood or no? So from here the food will come in the middle part. Here the intestinal glands will secrete intestinal juice which contains enzymes, and these enzymes will complete the breakdown of nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins and fats. Understood? And after that, these digested nutrients are absorbed by the intestine, about which we will discuss in next class. So almost most of the part we have covered, only a little part is left, that is the absorption of the digested food. So I hope it is clear. So in the small intestine, the digestion of the food is complete. Understood? So now after the food is digested, the digested food, it has to be carried to the cells. Now how the food is carried to the cells? It is carried by the blood to the cells. Okay, and how through the blood it is carried to the cells, that we will discuss in next chapter, next class. Understood all of you? I hope everyone has understood. If any one of you have any doubt, you can clarify your doubts. Okay, so this all we have done. So in the next class we will discuss about digestion, human digestion, and we will start with respiration. Okay, so I will give you some introduction on respiration. I hope it is clear to everyone. So you can see respiration we will do. Then this chapter is very very long, students. Okay, so homework I will give you in the next class. If you have any doubt, please clarify your doubts. Thank you, students.